subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw. Hey guys, before I begin, I'd like to tell you that lots happened in courts this week across the country. From suo motu petitions highlighting various issues being taken up in the top court to developments that made headlines in the high courts and other courts. The week was pretty interesting, at least legally. I'm excited to take you through these updates. So what am I waiting for? I'm Sanya for LiveLaw in June's second week of courts this week. Supreme Court updates first. In its suo motu case pertaining to the migrant crisis, Supreme Court passed several directions to the state governments, such as transporting migrant workers within 15 days to their native places, considering withdrawal of cases against migrants for alleged lockdown violations. The case will now be heard on July 8 in order for the court to take stock of progress made in this regard. Supreme Court took suo motu cognizance of the treatment of COVID patients and undignified handling of dead bodies and issued notices to Delhi, Maharashtra, West Bengal, Gujarat and Tamil Nadu governments. The court's own motion came in light of a news report that was telecast on India TV on June 10th showing hapless patients at LNJP hospital in Delhi. Bench noted that the sorry state of affairs had emerged in some states, depicting images of dead bodies being thrown in garbage bins. The bench also pulled up the Delhi government for low COVID testing rates. This matter will now be taken up on June 17. Top Court passed orders in the issue of challenge to the Ministry of Home Affairs order of March 29, stipulating full payment of wages to employees during the lockdown. The court stated that establishments and workers shall negotiate on full payment of wages regardless of the MHA order, and the state governments were to effectuate this. Apart from that, the bench noted that this ongoing negotiation would not mean that workers cannot continue working in the said establishments. Coercive action against employers who do not pay full wages shall continue. The adjusted gross revenue issue came up for hearing. Court asked the Department of Telecommunications to reconsider claims raised on PSUs basis the October 2019 verdict, stating that it amounted to a misuse of the said verdict. Let me give you some background to this. So on October 24, 2019, the Supreme Court had directed the telecom giants Vodafone, Bharti Airtel and Tata Teleservices to pay AGR dues of 92,000 crores with an interest rate of 8% per annum. On March 16 this year, the union through DOT moved the top court, praying that the telcos be allowed to make the payment in a staggered fashion spanning over a period of 20 years. The bench on that date had lashed out at the centre, stating that the assessment of this time frame at their own accord was uncalled for, but listed the matter for 2 weeks after. Last week, when the matter was finally taken up, the bench also directed the telecom firms to square in on a suitable time frame for payment of AGR and file affidavits in this regard. It'll now come up for hearing on June 18. The Supreme Court on Thursday issued notice in petitions seeking NIA and CBI probe into the Palghar lynching case. The bench issued notice in the petitions filed by Hindu sadhus of Sri Panch Dashban Juna Akhada and relatives of the two deceased sadhus, alleging bias by the state authorities currently investigating the matter. In a relief to thousands of home buyers of the stalled Amrapali project, the Supreme Court directed all financial institutions to disburse their balance funds and restructure the amounts despite being declared NPAs. In the suo motu case pertaining to the spread of coronavirus in children's shelter homes, court sought status report in the form of a questionnaire from different states' government on steps taken to protect children in shelter homes from the deadly novel coronavirus and also compliance of its earlier April 3rd order. The bench also took note of the recent incident of 35 children testing positive for coronavirus in a government-run shelter home in Royapuram, Chennai, and sought a status report from the state government of Tamil Nadu and secretary regarding reasons for the spread of the contagion and steps taken to control its further spread. In the plea filed by the Uttar Pradesh Prathmik Shiksha Mitra Association, challenging the recruitment of 69,000 assistant teachers, the top court directed the Uttar Pradesh government to keep 37,339 posts of assistant teachers vacant, thereby staying the ongoing selection process of teachers in the state. The Supreme Court imposed a cost of Rs. 5 lakh on a social worker who had filed a plea seeking ban and prohibition on the sale and use of Coca-Cola, Thumbs Up and other soft drinks, citing health concerns on their consumption. The bench observed that the petitioner lacked technical knowledge on the subject and his assertions stood unsubstantiated. The Foundation of Media Professionals filed a contempt petition in the Supreme Court over non-constitution of Special Committee to review J&K internet curbs. On May 11, the bench headed by Justice N.B. Ramana had directed that a special committee be constituted to immediately determine the necessity of continued restriction of mobile internet speeds in Jammu and Kashmir to 2G only. High courts and other courts now. The Bombay High Court reserved its verdict in Arnab Goswami's application for quashing of two FIRs filed against him on allegations of inciting religious groups through his shows on Republic TV and Republic Bharat about the Palghar mob lynching incident and the incident of migrants gathered outside of Bandra station during lockdown. The Delhi High Court has temporarily stayed the investigation against Vinod Dua in an FIR which alleges him of spreading misinformation and causing communal enmity on his YouTube channel. The FIR stated that allegedly a section of Vinod Dua's YouTube show, which had talked about the riots that had happened in Northeast District of Delhi, was spreading misinformation and rumors, and that his comments or remarks in the webcast contained communal overtones. Rajasthan High Court issued directions for termination of rape victim pregnancies and made significant remarks regarding the right of a minor rape victim to make reproductive choices. While doing so, the court noted that the right of a child rape victim to make the reproductive choice of terminating the fetus heavily outweighs the right of the child in the womb to be born, even where the pregnancy is at an advanced stage. Delhi High Court refused to entertain a PIL seeking information of PM CARES Fund. Court noted that no application has ever been preferred by the said petitioner seeking information under the Right to Information Act 2005. We therefore see no reason to entertain this writ petition at this stage as a public interest litigation, the court noted. Gujarat High Court issued contempt notice against Gujarat High Court Advocates Association President Yatin Oza for scurrilous remarks against High Court and its registry. During a Facebook live telecast, Oza had made comments like the registry of the court is corrupt, practices favoring of the influential rich smugglers and traitors. Oza has preferred an appeal against this order in the top court as well. Delhi High Court constituted a committee of doctors to inspect the feasibility of certain hotels to be used as extended COVID hospitals by the Delhi government to check whether using these hotels as COVID facilities would have any adverse effect on the staff working therein. The single bench of Justice Naveen Chawla has asked the said committee to look into the matter and submit a report on or before June 14. The Allahabad High Court stayed the interim order passed by a single judge of the High Court, staying the recruitment process of 69,000 assistant basic teachers in Uttar Pradesh. The bench has, however, clarified that the state government will be at liberty to
to continue with the selection process for 37,000 posts that were kept vacant for Shiksha Mitras in terms of the Supreme Court order dated June 9 in Subedar Singh and others versus State of UP and others. Bombay High Court gave a stern warning to Sarita Saukuvar, a woman accused by her own elderly mother of torturing her both mentally and physically. The court heard the petition filed by the 70-year-old Rajni Saukumar, who alleged that her daughter Sarita, who is a divorcee and is forcefully residing in her flat with her 19-year-old son, tortures her both mentally and physically. Rajni had sought her daughter's eviction from the said flat. Court stated that even if there is one more complaint of harassment, she will not be allowed to enter the flat where she is residing with her 19-year-old son and mother. 19-year-old Amulya Leona has been granted default bail by the magistrate court after the police failed to file the charge sheet within the stipulated 90-day period. She was arrested in February on sedition charges for allegedly raising pro-Pakistan slogans at an anti-CAA protest site. On June 12, however, the Sessions Court had rejected her application for regular bail, observing that the IO had not completed the investigation and had not filed the charge sheet. If the petitioner is released on bail, she may abscond or she may involve in similar offence which affects the peace at large, the court noted. Another week, another episode ends. Thanks for tuning in. Found this information helpful? Please like and share it. Subscribe to our channel for similar updates. See you next week.
Subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon to never miss a video from LiveLaw.